Hi all, welcome back. In today's video, we will explore two powerful functions from the NumPy library that can supercharge your data analysis in Pandas. They are np.where and np.select. These functions allow us to efficiently create new variables based on the conditional logic. So let's dive in and see how they work. But before that, let's explore a dataset on which we are going to work on. Let's import the necessary Python libraries for this session. They are Pandas and NumPy. The dataset that we'll be working with is tableau superstore dataset. Let's use the pandas read_csv method to read it. To obtain general information about the superstore dataset, one can use pandas info method. As you can see here, the superstore dataset contains 9,994 records and 20 variables. Furthermore, it specifies the variable names and data types, such as order ID being an object data type and order date being a date time data type and so on. The column names in the CSV file are in proper format with spaces between them and some of them have dashes. Let me use this piece of code to tidy them up. This will generate camel format column names and replace spaces and dashes with underscores. Now let's use pandas head method to view the first 5 records. And after doing some data wrangling, this is how our data looks like. I have created a subset of df data frame named df_subset that includes variables customer_id, customer_name, region, order_date, product_name, sales, quantity, and discount. First, let's start with np.where method. This function helps us create new variables based on single condition. Now let's do an example and see how we can create new variable using np.where method. df_subset, and we are going to create a new variable called sales_1000, and I'm going to call here np.where. In this example, we will create a new variable called sales_1000 based on sales column. And if the sales is greater than or equal to 1000, the value will be yes, otherwise no. So let me call our dataset df_subset, and let me call the variable sales greater than or equal to 1000. If it is yes, if it is true, then yes, otherwise no. Let's run the code. Oh, my bad. A spelling mistake. Now let's see how our data looks like. And you can see here, we have created a new variable called sales_1000 based on this particular condition. So there are 9,994 records. Let's see how many customers are there with greater than 1000 sales. df_subset. sales_1000 equal to yes. Let me call customer_id. Let me use nUnique method. So there are 339 customers who made a purchase of 1000 or more. Let's see how many total number of unique customers are there. Subset, then customer ID, _ID, .nUnique. So there are total 793 unique customer in our data set, which is, if you will divide 339 by 793, it will be around 43% of the customers who had made a purchase of 1000 or more. Now let's explore np.select function. This function allows us to create new variables with multiple conditions. Now let's do an example. In this example, we will create a new variable called sales_bins based on different sales ranges. We will define the conditions and corresponding choices using list. The default value is NA if none of the conditions are met. Now let's see how we can do that. Let me define my conditions in a list. I'm going to call my dataset df underscore subset and calling my variable sales less than 100. Another condition, df underscore subset, sales dot between 100 and 300. Let me copy this one. Another condition will be between 300 and 1000. And last condition will be sales greater than 1000. Now I'm going to create another list where we are going to name them the categories, which is low, average, if the second condition is met, if third condition is met, it is called above average. If our last condition is met, where sales is greater than 1000, it is called as high. Now let me call my dataset df underscore subset, and I'm going to call the new variable as sales underscore bin. And now let me call np.select method. The first thing which I'll input here is conditions. Then the categories will be mentioned here, which is in the form of the list choices. And default value is unknown, NA, if none of the condition is met. Let's run the code. So you can see here, the code has run successfully. Let's see how our data looks like. I'm calling the head method to see the top 5 records. And you can see here, we have successfully created our new variable called sales underscore bin based on these conditions. And we have called the categories within the new variables. We have called the categories as low, average, above average, and high on the basis of these conditions. So you can see here the sales value lies between 100 and 300, and it is correctly defined as average. When the sales value is between 300 and 1000, here you can see 731.94, it is above average. And there you have it. You have learned how to use np.where and np.select method to create new variables based on conditional logic in Pandas. These functions are incredibly useful for data manipulation and feature engineering tasks. Remember to import the necessary libraries, NumPy and Pandas, before using them in your code. Now it's your turn to apply these techniques to use your own data analysis projects. This example allows us to conclude this session. Moreover, I will write a community post informing you of the subject of the upcoming session. Take care and have a great day.